So we've seen two examples of the butterfly effect, or sensitive dependence on initial conditions. The first example was the logistic equation with r equals 4, and the second example was the Lorentz equations, a differential equation. So now let me define sensitive dependence on initial conditions, SDIC, a little more carefully, and then I'll be in a position to define chaos more carefully. Okay, so the idea behind sensitive dependence on initial conditions is this. We say that a dynamical system has sensitive dependence on initial conditions if very small differences in initial conditions, so we've got two orbits that start off very close together, that after a little while, the difference between those initial conditions become large. And we saw that perhaps most clearly for the logistic equation, where I actually was plotting the difference between those two orbits. So there's a more formal definition, and I don't want to get bogged down in it too much, but on the other hand, some of you might like to see this formalism, and the notion of the butterfly effect is perhaps the central thing, or one of the central things, and maybe the most popularized idea from chaos. So it's worth, I think, seeing what the sort of formal definition looks like. Okay, so here's the formal definition. I'll state this and then try to translate this into something a little bit more understandable. Okay, so we have a function f, or more generally a dynamical system, and let x naught and y naught be two possible seeds, two different initial conditions. And so we would say that this dynamical system or function has sensitive dependence on initial conditions if the following conditions are met. There needs to be some number delta such that for any initial condition x naught, there is some other initial condition y naught that's within epsilon of delta. That's within epsilon of x naught. It's not more than epsilon away from this first initial condition. Moreover, this initial condition y naught has the property that there's some number n, so that after n iterates, the orbit of y naught is more than delta away from the orbit of x naught. So in other words, xn, the nth iterate of x, minus yn, the nth iterate of y, is greater than this number delta. Okay, so this is certainly abstract, and I think the best way to illustrate this is to imagine a game of sorts. So here's how to think, how I imagine thinking about this game. So you're going to give me a puzzle, and you get to choose the following. So you get to choose an initial condition x naught. And let's say you can just choose whichever initial condition you want. Let's think about the logistic equation. So it has to be a number between 0 and 1. So let's say you choose 0.7. Okay. Then you get to choose some error threshold. That's delta. So this is a lowercase Greek delta. And again, this has to be between 0 and 1. Let's say you choose 0.2. And then the last thing you get to choose is the initial error epsilon. And let's say you choose 0.1. Okay, so you make these choices of these three numbers for the logistic equation, and then the puzzle is I have to come up with the following. So the puzzle, the task for me is, can I find a y naught, some other initial condition that's within 0.1 of 0.7, that's within epsilon of the x naught you chose. And this y naught that I find has to have the following property. There's some n, number of iterates, such that after that, or at that iterate, the nth iterate of xn is now more than 0.2 away from the nth iterate of yn. So the puzzle for me is I need to find a y naught that has this property. Can I do it? I'm pretty sure I can. I'll use the program that we were using earlier on the web to see if I can find a y naught that meets this criteria. Okay, so I'm looking for a y naught that's within 0.1 of 0.7. So let's see. I should have mentioned that this is for the logistic equation with r equals 4.0, since we're looking at the aperiodic chaotic case. And so for x naught, I choose 0.7. Well, I typed that in, but you chose that for me in this task that you've given me. And I need to choose some other initial condition that's close to 0.7. How close? It can't be more than epsilon away. The epsilon you gave me is 0.1. I'll try 0.72. That meets the criteria. And then I'm going to make the time series plots. And now here we have, in green and in purple, the two orbits, the orbit of x naught equals 0.7 and the orbit of the seed y naught equals 0.72. And now I want to see if I can find some n such that the orbits at that n are more than 0.2 apart. So let's see. Well, we can see right here, by the time we get to 5, the difference between the two, or the absolute value of the difference between the two, looks to be about 0.6. And if I go down further and I look in the table of numbers here on the right, I can see indeed that by the fifth iterate, the difference between, or the absolute value of the difference between the two orbits, is greater than the delta you gave me, 0.2. So yes, I can find a y naught within 0.1 of the initial condition 0.7, such that after some amount of iterates, it's more that the difference between the two orbits is greater than 0.2. So the answer to this question is yes. And in particular, I found that y naught is 0.72, then so if y naught, if I choose a y naught of 0.72, then I iterated my y naught and my x naught. They started off within epsilon of each other, and then after 5 iterates, the difference between these two, the absolute value, is about 0.63, and 0.63 is, the key thing is that this, is larger than delta. So you said I had to make it larger than 0.2. No problem. In fact, I got it a lot larger than 0.2. Okay, so this is just one particular case, one particular choice of x naught, delta, and epsilon. So if a function has sensitive dependence on initial conditions, I have to be able to answer this question with yes for whatever you choose for these three things. Again, as long as you don't do something crazy like choose a delta greater than 1. So if we're talking about the logistic equation, everything has to be between 0 and 1. So as long as you choose reasonable or not crazy numbers here, for any reasonable choice of these three numbers, I can always answer this question yes. So what this means is that any initial condition you choose, and you can choose a really big error threshold, 0.9, 0.99 if you wanted, and you could choose a really small epsilon. Maybe I can even draw this. So here's the initial condition x naught, and you choose that, And then there's going to be some little thing. This will be x naught plus epsilon, x naught minus epsilon. So somewhere in here, I can find an initial condition y naught such that after some amount of iterates, these two points are arbitrarily far apart, any delta you choose. So if a function has sensitive dependence on initial conditions, any initial condition very close to that initial condition is another initial condition which eventually gets very far away. So that's the formal definition for sensitive dependence on initial conditions. Here's that long wordy thing. It's an awful run-on sentence, but I didn't really know another way to write it. This is a standard definition. You can find it, I'm sure, on Wikipedia or in any text if you wanted. And it's quite general. We need to have, f just needs to be a function that maps a space to itself. The space needs to be a metric space because we have to have some notion of distance. But that's really the only requirement for being able to use this definition. So it applies to a whole lot of dynamical systems, not just iterated functions.